Hi everyone. So next we'll go with the chapter Wave Optics. Here mainly I concentrate on the interference and YDAC, Youngster Velocity Experiment. So before that we'll go with some basics, what is required to explain the interference. So usually know when we take the wave nature of light, already we have explained in the beginning of ray optics. Suppose here most of you explained on the interference pattern. In interference pattern, we are going to use two slits, okay? So here your wave is coming or light is coming, you can say. So suppose if wavelength of this wave, you can take it as say 4000 angstrom, and what would be the width of this slit? Width of slit you can take it as say 0.003 millimeter, okay? So if you write this, if you convert into, or if you compare lambda and d, so lambda is what, 4 into 10 to power minus 7 meter, and d is what, this is nothing but 3 into millimeter, means this will become 10 to power minus 6. So if you compare the lambda and d, they are very much close. The d is very much close with the lambda, or comparable with the lambda. That means dimensions of the body, or dimensions of the slit or whatever you are using, or obstacle, that is comparable with the wavelength of lambda. If this condition satisfies, so we can consider the wave nature of light. Wave nature of light. Okay. So to explain many things in the wave chapter, we need the equation of wave. Okay. So what will be the equation of wave? Usually how you will get the wave? Wave is nothing but what? It is not a transfer of particle. It is a transfer of what? It is transfer of energy. Okay. Suppose if you take this is the wave. So this wave is coming because of what? Because of oscillations of the particle. Suppose here is one particle. This particle is oscillating about the mean position. Again, this particle is oscillating about the mean position. So you are getting a wave. So you are getting a wave. This is what happened. The particles are oscillating about their mean position. Suppose when we know they are oscillating, so obviously we can write the equation for this particle. I am not writing equation for a wave. I am writing the equation for this particle. For this particle, for example, at t equals to 0, so I will write it as equation is y equals to say a sin omega t. Okay. So this is what the SHM equation or oscillation equation for particle at t equals to 0. Okay, or at this position. Now if I take another particle here, I will not take in between particle. I am taking this particle because they are the similar. They together go to the extreme position, they together come to the mean position. I cannot take these two. They are not doing the same thing. Okay, so if at t equals to t dash, if you consider this particle is at the same position as the first particle. Or this particle is doing the same work as first particle is doing. Okay. If you want to write the equation for this particle, so what you can write? This particle is doing the same thing, but after what? Say after some t dash time, okay? So this distance you can take it as x. At x distance, after t dash time, what this particle is doing? This particle is doing the same thing. That means the equation of this particle is same as the first, a sin omega t only. But how much time it is taking? After time t dash. So can I write this as a sin, you can take it as, what is the time? Time is omega t plus t dash. Okay. So why t plus t dash? T is the at time equals t equals to 0, omega t. So t dash is what? After that much time, this particle is doing the same thing. Okay. So now if I expand this equation, y equals to a sin omega t plus omega t dash. Okay. Suppose if you take velocity of a wave is v, and what is the distance traveled? Distance traveled is x. So can I write t dash as x divided by v? So y equals to a sin omega t plus omega. So x divided by v. So x, what you can write? Omega t, not x, omega. Omega can I write it as 2 pi, 2 pi f divided by v into x. Okay, so this is what the equation. So if you take f here, if you take this f here, so what will happen? V by f is nothing but what? V by f is nothing but lambda. So equation will become a sine omega t plus 2 pi by lambda into x. Okay, so in general this we call it as a constant called as k. Okay, so a sine omega t plus kx. Okay, so this is what equation of SHM. Okay, so with the help of this equation we can do the constructive and destructive interference. Okay, suppose if you take the, now I will apply this wave equation for the light. Suppose you are having the source over here. So this source at the time t equals to 0, its equation is what? Its equation I will take it as a sine omega t plus, just I will take it as omega t. Okay, suppose after traveling say at distance say x1, so what you can write? Or I will take it as general equation like omega t kx, because this is what general equation we got. Now at some distance say x1, what you will write? You will write as a sine omega t plus kx1. Again I will take another wave at this point, another particle at this point, not wave. So what is the x2 distance, what is the equation for this particle doing the same thing as this is doing? So you can write it as a sine omega t plus kx2. Okay, so this is what, at a different distances you will get the different equation for the oscillating particle and all together make the wave. Okay, now suppose there is a source. This source is producing light in all the directions, in this direction, here, in all the directions it is producing the what is ray of light, okay, or the wave. So what will happen? I will take one sphere over here, because you can think in the three dimensional, it is going in all the directions, so I will consider the sphere. Okay, so I will consider one more sphere over here. So this is what is going to be one more sphere. Now from here to here say distance is x1, and from here to here say distance is x2. So for this particle the equation is what? Equation you can write as y equals to a sine omega t plus kx1, sorry x2. Okay, so for this I will write it as equation as a sine omega t plus k x1. Okay, now if you find the phase difference between these two, what you will get the phase difference? Phase difference I will get it as omega t plus k x2 minus omega t minus k x1. So omega t will get cancelled, so k x2 minus x1, phase difference is not zero. Phase difference is not zero means they are not reaching the same place at same time. There is some path difference and phase difference. So these particles we cannot call it as they are in phase or they are in out of phase. Suppose instead of this particle, if I take another particle here only, so y equals to what I can write, again I will write as a sine omega t plus kx2 only. Okay, now if you look at these two equations, I am talking about these two particles. So what is the phase difference? Phase difference is going to be what? Zero. Omega to omega will get cancelled. Kx2 will get cancelled. If you take another particle here, y equals to a sine, again what you will write? Omega t plus kx2 only. Again, the phase difference between these two or these two, it will become what? It will become again zero. Okay? That means on this line, whatever the particles comes on this line, they all are in what? They all are in phase. They all are in phase. Okay? So, but these two are not in phase. This particle 2 and 1 particle is not in phase. But this 2 and 3 or four are in phase. Okay, so this locus of point, this locus of point where all the particles are in phase, locus of points where all the particles are in phase is called as wave front. Is called as wave front. So our whole discussion is standing on this word that is called as wave front. Okay, so wave front is what? It is the locus of points or at the surface where all the particles are in phase. All particles are in phase. Okay, or phase difference between the particles is what? Zero. Phase difference is zero. Okay, so wave front is the locus of points where all the particles are in phase. So now you got the what exactly wave front is. So we will see some of the properties of the wave front. Suppose you have a source here, so it is emitting the light in this direction. Okay, so now if you look at this surface or this wave front, we can say the direction of propagation of wave is always perpendicular to the wavefront. So direction of propagation of wave is normal to or perpendicular to wavefront. Okay, perpendicular to wavefront. So second thing, if I take two wavefronts, suppose this is the light propagating. Okay, so I will take one wavefront over here and another wavefront here. Okay, between any two wavefront, okay, here you can take one particle, here you can take one particle. So this is what it will take. The distance between these two, you can take as d1, and time taken you can take as t1. And what you can take, one more is velocity v1. If suppose medium is same, again if you take two particles over here, so again what will happen, again d1, t1 and v1 over here. Okay, suppose medium changes, when medium changes, what will happen, velocity will get changed. And when the light travel from rarer to denser medium, velocity will get changed. So this will become v2. Distance will also change. So if velocity changes, then distance covered will also change. So only thing which remains is time. Time will not change, okay? Because this wave, or in the definition of wavefront, what is going to remain same? The phase difference is going to remain same, okay? So it depends on the path. So it is not depend on the time. So time remains same when the medium changes. Only thing which remains same is time, okay? We can call it as time remains same between wavefronts. Okay, between wavefronts. Okay, so this is what, and most important point, that is third point. Suppose if this is the light propagating, so you will take one wavefront here. So every particle on this wavefront, or I will take one more wavefront over here. Okay, so every particle on this wavefront will be the source of new waves, or this will emit the energy again. Okay, so every point on this wavefront become or acts as what? New source of light called as secondary wavelets. Okay, secondary wavelets. Again, this will emit the light. Okay, so every particle on the wavefront acts as a new source of light. Okay, so then this is what the Huygen wanted to say, and that is what comes in his principle. Okay, next thing, what will happen? Suppose there is a particle. Okay, if there is a particle, it is emitting the new light, or it is a source of new light energy. So what is happening? So it is emitting light in all directions. Okay, so the energy propagation by the secondary source is maximum in the direction of propagation of wave. Suppose it is coming here, so initially it is in direction of propagation. So the energy produced by this secondary source is maximum in the direction of propagation of light. If you take in this direction, so both will get cancelled, it may become zero. Here they may get little, here they may get reduced. So in this direction they will add. So what will happen? So energy is maximum. Energy is maximum. That is what energy of the new light produced by the secondary source. So energy is maximum in the direction of propagation of wave. Okay. So this is what these are the what important properties. Based on this, and these are the what the points what Huygens suggested. And one more thing he suggested, what is that? How to find the new wavefront? So how we can get the new wavefront? That can be done with the help of Huygens principle. What he suggested, suppose there is a source of energy, so this is producing the light, okay? So this is what the wavefront, okay? So this is the wavefront, say at t equals to 0. This is the wavefront, say at t equals to 0. Now what we want, how to find the new wavefront? Now, if you consider these particles, so these particles again what become the source of again light. So what will happen? This will produce the light in this direction. Okay. So these all are producing the light. So these are what the waves produced by the particle on the wavefront. Okay. So this is what. Okay. So if you take another particle, so this is also what producing the energy, or you can say light. So now if you take the wavefronts of this one, this will become what wavefront. This is becoming a wavefront for this one, and this is what one wavefront. So this is what the wavefront. Now he suggested, if you want to get wavefront, if you want to get wavefront at t equals to t, this is what wavefront at t equals to 0. If you want to find the wavefront at t equals to t, he suggested, draw the tangents to secondary wavelets. So draw the tangents to secondary wavelets. So then what will happen? The envelope formed, the envelope formed by these tangents, okay? This is what the envelope is going to form, okay? So this envelope will give you what? Will give you new wavefront. This will give you the new wavefront, or that is what wavefront at time t equals to, you can say t equals to t. Okay. Now we may get the doubt that we can get one more wavefront on this side also. Okay. So which wavefront we have to consider? We have to consider only this wavefront, which is in forward direction, because this wavefront is going to get cancelled, because energy going in this direction, initial energy, so new energy is coming opposite to this one. We know that intensity is directly proportional to 1 plus cos theta or cos phi. Okay, this will understand later when we derive the intensity formula. So if they are opposite, theta or pi will become, or pi will become 180. So I is directly proportional to 1 plus cos 180. Cos 180 is what? Minus 1. So what will happen? Intensity is going to be what? Intensity is going to be 0. So that is why in reality you will not see any wavefront in this direction, or in the wavefront which is just before the wavefront at t equals to 0. So that is why we have to consider only wavefront in forward direction. Wavefront in forward direction. Okay. So this is what, how we can find the wavefront at t equals to at time or t equals to t, when we know the wavefront at t equals to 0. So next we'll go with the types of wavefront which you already know in your theory part. So types of wavefronts. So if the source is point source, suppose you are having the point source, so what will happen? So this point source emit the light in all the directions. Okay, so it is going in all the directions. Now suppose if you want to find the shape of wavefront, then what you have to do, you have to measure in three dimensions. So you have to take one sphere. Okay, so this is what going to be the wavefront at say at distance x. So all the particles are at the same distance x only. Okay, so now if this is the case, so if you look at the shape of the wavefront, so what is the shape? Shape is the sphere. So that is why this is called as what? This is called as spherical wavefront. Okay, so this is called as spherical wavefront. And what is the source? Source should be what? Point source. Source should be point source. Okay, so this is what the first one. Suppose instead of point source, suppose this is the line source or source of say length L, like your tube light. If this is the source, so what will happen? It will emit the radiations in all the direction in this way. Okay, so this is what going to be the light waves produced by the line source. Okay, so not only in this direction, this is going in this direction also. Okay, so everywhere this is going in this direction also, same here also. Okay, so if you want to get the, or if you want to draw the line perpendicular to all these, so you are going to get a cylinder. So here in all directions light rays are there, means you have to take in this way, then you have to take in this way. Okay, so what will happen? This shape looks like a cylinder. So this is called as what? This is called as cylindrical wavefront. Okay, so for cylindrical wavefront, so what is the source? Source should be what? Source should be line source. Okay, it should be a line source. Now whether it is a line source or it is the point source, if you put that source at the longest distance, suppose at infinite distance, so one source is there, it may be a line source or point source. So what will happen? That the ray of light will come. So it is coming from some distance, means. So at infinite distance, what will happen? So rays will become what? Parallel. Okay. So rays will become what? Parallel. So now if you draw the perpendicular plane over here, this is what going to be wavefront shape. Okay, so this is what going to be your wavefront shape. So this is called as what? This is called as the plane wavefront. Okay, plane wavefront or planar wavefront. So these are your three types of wavefront. And for this, a source should be what? Source should be at infinite, whether it is line or whether it is point source. So source should be at infinite source. So we can simply write it as infinite source. Okay. So totally there are three types: spectral wavefront, cylindrical wavefront, and plane wavefront or planar wavefront. Okay. So now if they ask you to the shape of new wavefront, suppose an infinite ray of light is going, so what will be the wavefront? Wavefront is going to be what? Wavefront is going to be planar or plane wavefront. Okay, this is what plane wavefront. Suppose if I kept one convex lens over here, so what will happen? They tend to converge at the principal focus. Okay, so what will happen? They will converge at some principal focus. Now what will be the new wavefront? New wavefront is you have to draw normally. So new wavefront will be what? New wavefront will be spherical. Okay, similarly if suppose what will happen, if this is the length, suppose there is a point source, so ray of lights are going here. Okay, so now what will be the new wavefront? Now what I will say, so this is your principal focus. Suppose this is your principal focus, so what will happen? Ray of light will become parallel to principal axis. So here it is what? Here it is spherical, and now here it will become what? Here it will become plane wavefront. Okay, so this is what going to be linear frame. Okay. Similarly, now how we can twist here is, so focal length of this is 10, and the source of light is say at a distance say 15 centimeter. Okay. So focal length is 10 centimeter. Now ray of light will go. So here wavefront is what? Here wavefront is spherical. Okay. Now what will be the new wavefront? Without thinking of focal length and distance of source, what we do, we directly go for the plane wavefront. But it is not so. Why? If the source is at the principal focus, then only it will become parallel. Otherwise, again what will happen? It will converge only. Here focal length is 10 means principal focus will come here at a 10 centimeter distance. But object is there at what? Or source is there at 15 centimeters. So what will happen? After refraction, so then they will try to converge again. They will converge somewhere. Okay. So now what will happen? So again wavefront is going to be, what? Again it is the spherical only. So we should be very much careful while attempting these kind of questions. Okay. So we should be very much careful about focal length and distance of the source where it is kept. Simply we should not go for the plane. Okay. So similarly in case of mirror also, if this is the concave mirror, if a ray of light is coming from infinite, so before reflection what will happen? Before reflection it is going to be plane wavefront. So after reflection, if they ask what will be the shape of wavefront, after reflection again it is going to be what? It is going to be spherical. Okay. So instead of this one, if you take the prism, so here a ray of light is going. So what is the shape of the wavefront? Shape of wavefront is here, it is plane. So same deviations taken by both the rays. So again here what will happen? Here again it is going to be plane wavefront only. Okay. So we should be very much careful. We should take care that this wavefront should be perpendicular, surface of wavefront should be perpendicular to the direction of propagation of light. Okay. So now they may ask questions like this. Suppose there is a medium. So this is what air, and this you can take it as glass. Okay. So suppose a ray of light is coming from here. Okay. So a ray of light is coming from here. So this is what the wavefront. So it is what plane wavefront. Suppose this incident on this surface. So this is making, this wavefront is making angle say some 50 degree with horizontal. Okay. Now question is, what is the angle made by a new wavefront in this medium? So with the horizontal. So what we can write? Angle or which of following true? So angle made by new wavefront. Angle made by new wavefront with horizontal in glass. So in glass. So what will happen? So answers may be say option A you can take it as 50 degree only, or option B you can take it as less than 50 degree, or option C you can take it as greater than 50 degree, or D you can take it as it is going to be zero. Okay. So now it is traveling from radar to denser means what will happen? Ray of light bent towards the normal. So it is coming towards the normal. Okay. Now where is the wavefront? Wavefront is going to be here. This is what the wavefront, so normal to this one. Now this is what the angle made by the new wavefront. So this is what new wavefront in the denser medium. So this is what our new angle. So if you look at new angle, so here it was 50 degree. Now when it comes here, it became smaller because a ray bent towards the normal means. So this is coming closer to the horizontal. So obviously theta is less than your initial angle, that is less than 50 degrees. So your answer is going to be B. So whenever a ray of light comes from radar to denser medium, the angle made by the wavefront with the horizontal is always less than the angle made by the wavefront with the horizontal in radar medium. Okay, so reverse is true in case of when light travels from denser to radar. Or sometimes they may ask angle only. Suppose this is what the glass. This is what the glass, and this is I will take as A. So this is the normal. A ray of light comes and incident at an angle of say 37 degree. Okay, so if it incident at an angle of 37 degree, they will ask angle made by wavefront. Angle made by wavefront with horizontal. Angle made by wavefront with horizontal in tensor medium or in glass. Okay. Or in glass, whatever. So how we can do this one? Now we can if I take the diagram over here. So what is happening? This is the ray of light coming. This is what wavefront. Okay. Now don't worry about wavefront. We don't want angle here. So that is plane wavefront. Here it is 37 degree. So here refractive index is what? Refractive index of glass is of 1.5. So I will take it as 3/2. So find how we can find the angle made by wavefront with the horizontal. Suppose this is the ray of light after the refraction. So now if you take, this is what the new wavefront. This is what new wavefront. Okay. So what will happen now? See here. What they are asking, this angle theta they are asking. See, this is 90 degree. This is the angle of incident and this is what angle of refraction. This is 90, this is R, this is going to be what? This is going to be 90 minus R. If this is 90 minus R, this angle is going to be what? This angle is going to be obviously R. Okay. So that is why. So this theta is nothing but what? It is nothing but equals to R only. This is nothing but equals to R. So if you find R, you can get the theta value. So apply this Stenner's law, n1 sin I equals to n2 sin R. So n1 is one air medium, sin 37 degree equals to, this is what, 3/2 sin R. So what sin 37? So sin 37 you can write it as 3/5 is equals to 3/2 sin of R. So 3 will get cancelled. R equals to sin inverse of 2/5. Okay, this is what the angle made by new wavefront. So this is what angle made by new wavefront with the horizontal. So that is what sin inverse of 2/5. Okay. So this is how we can calculate the angles of wavefronts with the horizontal. Or they may ask in other ways also.